I'm going to show the steps I use to read and write to a SQLite database using Entity Framework Core and VB.NET. The SQLite database I'll connect to is on the desktop. It has two tables, video types and videos. I'll show how the database can be created at the end. I have the database open in the command prompt. There are 5 records in the video types table and 3 records in the videos table. I'm using Visual Studio 22 with a .NET 8 WinForms project loaded. First, I'll open Nuget Manager to add a database provider. Search for microsoft.entityframeworkcore.sqlite. Install it to the project. It requires the latest .NET version before it will install. That can be changed in the Project Properties Application section. Once it's done, it's shown in the Install tab. Next, I create classes to represent the table data. First is the video class. I use property names that match the database color names, so they're automatically mapped to each other. If they didn't match, I can use data annotations above the properties to map them. This navigation property on line 7 allows me to include the video type when loading videos from the database. Here's the video type class. Now I need to create a DbContext class that will handle the database transactions. I'll name it Media Library Context. It has a DbSet property for both tables and overrides onConfiguring to set the connection string. Now I'll read from the database in Form 1. This is handled in the ShowVideos method. It uses the context to load all videos and the related video type to a list. Then it adds each video to a list view. I'll run it, and it shows the 3 records in the database. Next, I'll show how inserts and updates are handled in the add edit form. I'm determining if it's an add or edit with a flag in each constructor. Here's how I load the video types from the database. Show video displays the fields if it's an edit. In the save click event, a new video is declared and its properties are set from the interface. If it's an edit, it restores the original ID and updates the context. If it's an add, it sets the ID to nothing, so we'll auto increment and adds to the context. Then context.save changes writes to the database. After save changes, the video will be refreshed with a new ID if I need to insert it into other tables. Back on Form 1, here's how the add click event is handled. In the edit click event, I use context.find to locate the selected video. And to delete records, I use context.find and context.remove. I'll run it, add a record, edit the record, and delete a record. To create a database if it doesn't exist, I use context.database.insureCreated. To add video types when a database is created, I override the onCreated method in the context class. To demo that, I'll delete the database, run it, and it created the database on the desktop again. If I open the add form, the video types were created as well. So that's it. It was a simple example, but hopefully it's helpful if you're new to EF Core.